Good afternoon. Welcome to River Valley Christian Church. We are here today to celebrate the life of Joan Vocke. So I can like an owner of Joan's street.
Name at birth.
Some of you who know her. Joan.
And so many are here today to celebrate her life.
And that song you just heard, that's the one she loved. For you to see and
know and believe that the Lord is with
you to be trusted
and obeyed. I don't know if you come with a cell
phone, you might have silence this morning. That might seem some distraction and that's to be
together. But we want to concentrate. Literally felt the presence of God. Now, one of the things I've learned in my 67 years of life is I can never feel the presence of God without a newborn. I don't know about you, but if you've ever held a newborn baby or seen your child birth and you hold that child, your first thought is, this is a miracle. This is a gift from God. There is a God in you. She knew Christ.
She followed God. She invested her life in helping make other disciples to follow Christ. She raised the family to know the Lord. She had trusted and obeyed, so as much as it hurt to hear she was gone, I was okay.
I could feel the presence of God, and I hope somehow. And then Friday came. Wow.
I want you to know that you're contributing
to Joey. For a life of service
to the family, to God, to the community she lives in.
Secondly, we're here to
encourage this family mostly about one thing. Death and the celebration of life. Time we gather gives you a chance to pat each other on the back. I appreciate the time you give me to show up. Your presence means the world to me. And I've heard the encouraging words.
I've heard the conversation.
You're reminiscing about who she was, and though there's sadness, there's still joy because we're close to you.
just before Jesus went to the cross, he do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I am to prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you may be where I am. And he told those in the upper room, those who spent 3 years with him, you know the way to the place where I'm going. And there's one in the room, Thomas. Lord, we don't know where you're going. It's happening in another way. Jesus answered a strong statement. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Her life. And she wants you to know that. And celebrate him as an awesome song. Would you pray with me right now? When we're done, we're going to talk about the rooms he prepared. We won't listen to this song. But I imagine that you should have experiences. And then I'd like tributes to children. I think we're planning a dear friend from childhood. I think maybe others as well, if you're willing. We'll have a time attributed after the song. Father, just now we use this service. We thank you so much for the life lived on Joan. We thank you for her faith in you, and may we lean on that faith even more. Father, may our faith grow, may our trust in you grow, even though we're sad she is not in our midst, and we believe she is in your presence. Father, just now, thank you for these who give a time for the promise of her life. They will hear and praise the Spirit. But Father, would you make your presence felt in this room? Your word says, where two or more are gathered in your name, you're in the midst. And we welcome you. May you surround us with your Holy Spirit and the comfort that comes from you, a peace that passes all understanding. It is in the powerful name of these things, and all his people say together with me, amen.
Yeah.
imagine the splendor of heaven she experiences now, and a chance to see her Lord and Savior face to face. That ought to give us hope.